explain a bit about the Rungler circuit?
Rungler, okay, yeah. The Rungler is basically, if you have a traditional synthesizer, you always see this module that says noise. Mostly it has no knob or anything, just an output, and it goes shh. Sometimes you have a knob that says brown noise or white noise or pink noise or something, but all it does, it goes shh. Now, in the Netherlands, in The Hague, there lives a composer. His name is Jan Boerman. He's already in his 80s, almost 90s now. And he is he was one of these people that in the early 60s made all these tape compositions where he would record sounds and then on tape, cut the tape in small pieces and then rearrange all these small pieces. He has one beautiful piece which is called The Sea. That's only an 8-minute piece, but that cost him 2 years of cutting and splicing tape. So you can sort of imagine. And this Jan Boerman had a very interesting theory, because he had this theory that he said that if you have sound, then at one side, at the most simple side, you have a sine wave. That is the most simple element that you can find in sound. At the other end, there is noise. Because the definition of noise is that basically it's a mix of every possible frequency, of every possible, at every possible amplitude, at any possible time. So everything, so he said, basically every sound is hidden somewhere in noise. So if you take a line between that sine wave and that noise, then every sound must be somewhere on that line. Now, I'm not really sure if you really look at this in a very scientific way of this theory actually holds, but it is a very interesting idea to take as a starting point to become creative, because we're artists, we're not scientists, so we don't have to prove scientifically that we are right. And this idea inspired me. He used it as the background principle to make his music, to compose his music. It's early electronic music, and it's quite worthwhile listening to. And I sort of had this idea like a noise generator should not just only produce noise, but if you have a module or a circuit that can do noise, but also can move somewhere in that area towards that sine wave, then probably you can create interesting kind of things, and the things that I'm then after are the more organic kind of patterns and things that came about. Then in the 80s there came this thing they called chaos theory. And chaos theory basically said that everything that we know is very complex systems that are really very well defined, but their complexity is so large that the human mind is simply not able to sort of grasp the workings of that of those processes, like the weather or the human body or, you know, all these natural things. And in chaos theory, they came up with some interesting things, that a chaotic signal is not a random signal, because chaos behaves in a certain way, and randomness does not behave, it's just random. You really don't know what will happen. But with chaos, you can basically, if you can do complex enough calculations, predict what will happen next. But there are certain patterns that repeat, and one of the things that is interesting is that you can have what they call bifurcations, which are called period doublings. But as a wave cycle has a period, if you double the time of that period, that means that you actually get an octave lower. So you can create, you can not only create higher pitches from a pitch, but you can also create lower pitches, and which I actually can demonstrate, because it's in the system. Should be possible to do. Because if I have I have a filter here, and if I feed that filter a sine wave at a high resonance,
thank you.
distortion that is actually a sort of chaotic distortion. And then suddenly my sine wave goes an octave lower. Because in essence, because a filter is a feedback system, the moment when you apply non-linear feedback, a system automatically becomes potentially chaotic. And you can actually listen here that this sounds a bit like what happens if you have a blown instrument, the way how that sort of sometimes ends up in the attack. So I thought if you want to make a noise generator that can do a bit more than noise, then maybe it is interesting to see how you can combine this Jan Boerman idea with chaos theory ideas and sort of come up with a mix. But then very important is also that, because if you design stuff, very quickly it becomes complex, but then you have to simplify again before you come with your final thing. Because if you make it too complex, it becomes a pain in the ass to use. And nobody likes it. And actually, you want to make things that people like. And so you always have to, always when you think that you finished your design, first simplify, and then it's finished. So you think of all sorts of possibilities and combinations, etc., etc., etc. Then at a certain moment, you have this sort of like a picture, notes, etc., of like, okay, this is going to be the thing, and then you think like, oh, but this is much too complex. Let's take out the essential parts, the things that actually give produce the characters that I want, and not too much of them, because then in what way can I simplify things to make them recognizable with a certain character? So I actually used a shift register based circuit for the technicians amongst us, because with shift registers you can make so-called pseudo random generators, and the idea is what can you do, what variations can you come up with that you get something that is simpler than the pseudo random sequences that sound like noise. But still sort of does something. And I experimented a lot with these sort of chaos theory formulas that you find in the textbooks to apply them to music, and most of them was pretty disappointing what I did, until I realized that basically what you want in music is little patterns. Patterns that can behave like sequences, or patterns that at audio rate become more like tones and timbres. So if you just listen straight to the output of this module, then I can make it, set it in a way that it produces noise. And in this setting, it is just a standard pseudo-random digital noise generator, as undoubtedly there are 5 Eurorack modules that do exactly the same thing. You have a noise clock, also quite recognizable. And then if the clock is low, then basically you have a sort of a total random pattern. So if instead of listening to the pattern directly, I now actually listen to the output of a VCA and feed this of an oscillator and feed this pattern into the oscillator modulation input, this is totally random. So that means that it just goes nowhere, and actually that is of little musical use. So then the idea is, can I sort of shorten these patterns? And for that there's a little switch. And now, of course, because we have a shortened pattern, it's interesting, how can I change this pattern, but not constantly, but in a controlled way? And that you can... So you can hear that I can already create quite a lot of different kind of signals that create different kind of timbres, atmospheres, and when I modulate this oscillator. So this a shift register is basically a digital delay, but it is the worst kind of digital delay that you can imagine, because it's not 24 bits, it's not 16 bits, not even 8 bits, it's only 1 bit. And you drive it with a clock, and so it has a sample rate, and the length of these shift registers is not like 5 seconds at 48 kilohertz or something. No, it's only just like 8 or 16 locations. So it is a really simple circuit. But the way... And it has a data input, basically that is the 0 or the 1, because it doesn't accept more than, because it's 1 bit. But if you have a square wave or pulse wave oscillator, that is also a 1 bit signal, because it's only on or off. So if you use a square wave or pulse wave oscillator as the data input in this very short digital delay, and you take another oscillator to produce a clock, then basically what you do, you shift the pulses that come in slowly through those bits, and then at the output, yeah, you have 1 bit that is synchronized to the clock. But then you can do another trick, because one of the advantages of these shift registers is that all the separate bits that flow through this sort of little tube are actually available as outputs on the chips that do this. And so what you can do is you can take several of these outputs and think of them as maybe a 4-bit signal or a 3-bit signal, feed them to a digital to analog converter that changes that to voltage levels. So basically, you can hear that... We do have fixed voltage levels. Actually, I configured it in a way that it has 9 possible voltage level outputs. There's 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4 volts, minus 1, 2, 3, 4 volts, so it spans like 9 octaves is a full signal.
We need to get you to the airport.
Ah, sorry, people.
Sorry for the alarm.
That's for the alarm.
I'll be back next year.
Okay.
That's a problem. As you all know, modular synthesizers can never be big enough.